Hello, I'm Neil Forcier, an application engineer with Agilent Technologies, and I'm going to be talking to you about testing photovoltaics with a DC electronic load. So one great advantage to using a DC electronic load to test photovoltaic devices is its power handling capability. So right here I have the Agilent N3301A, and in this half rack 3U size, I can sink up to 600 watts of power. And a maximum of 120 amps in that small space. So the idea here is electronic loads have high power handling capability at a low cost. So I can get that 600 watts between 4 and 5K. So unlike a four quadrant DC power supply, an electronic load provides a much more inexpensive solution at high power handling capability. So it's great for testing high power, high current PV devices like large area cells, PV modules, PV panels, and also concentrated photovoltaics or CPV. So basically I'm going to show you an example where I'm going to run a simple test and capture the IV curve or the IV curve characteristics of a PV panel. So in my test setup, I have my DC electronic load, which I'm going to refer to as an E-load throughout the video. I have my boost power supply, which I'll talk about later and explain in more detail what a boost power supply is. And I have my PV panel. And then finally, I have my light source. Now, this is in no way the typical light source someone would use to test photovoltaics, but for the budget of this video, it's just a low-cost light to basically prove the functionality of what I'm going to show you. So you heard me mention one of the great advantages to using a DC electronic load for PV testing is its high power handling capabilities at a fairly low cost. And that's compared to four quadrant power supply type devices. Now, the other great thing about a DC electronic load is it has the built-in voltage and current measurements, so you don't need an outside instrument to monitor the voltage and current. So for instance, Agilent's N3301A has current and voltage measurement capabilities built in parallel, so it can measure voltage and current. Also, it's in the form of digitizers, voltage and current digitizers, so you can control how fast you want to go through the curve. So for instance, if you're doing flash testing, you can easily cover a panel that's 250 watts, 50 volts open circuit voltage in 10 milliseconds. Or if you want higher accuracy, you can delay you can take longer digitized measurements and give you more average measurements for higher accuracy. So it's very flexible as far as time for measurement. So high power handling and flexibility and measurement capability is two advantages of using the electronic load. Okay, so before I get started on the test, let me explain the boost supply. So one characteristic of a DC electronic load is the fact that as you get closer to 0 volts, as the voltage drop across the electronic load leads get closer to 0 volts, its current handling capability begins to fall. And as you get around 0 volts, its current handling capability basically drops to zero. Now, for PV devices, this is a real problem because when we have 0 volts across our PV device under test, that's when it's in its short circuit condition. And that's where we want to measure the short circuit current flowing out of it. Well, if the electronic load can't measure any current at 0 volts, that's a real problem. Or I should say, can't sink any current at 0 volts, that's a real problem. So what we're going to use the boost supply is basically to combat that characteristic of electronic loads. And that's not for just Agilent electronic loads, that's for all electronic loads. So the N3301A in particular, its current handling capability begins to drop off around 2 volts. So I'm going to move quickly to a diagram and show you how the boost power supply is hooked up in the test system. So now you're looking at a schematic representation of the test setup we have. And you can see on the left, the PV device is our solar panel. Connected to the PV device all the way on the right is the electronic load. And there in the middle, connected between the common of the PV device and the common of the E-load, is the boost supply, which I pointed out. And the boost supply's job is to do exactly what its name says. It's to boost the voltage potential of the PV device up. So as I mentioned earlier, the E-load, its current handling capabilities begins to drop as the voltage begins to lower. So as I said, for the Agilent E-load, that happens around 2 volts. So we're gonna set our boost supply for 3 volts just to be safe. And so that's gonna keep our PV device at a potential of 3 volts at all times. So if you look on the bottom here, we have some writing, and basically when the boost supply is at 3 volts and the E-load has a 3 volt drop across it, there is a 0 volt potential across the PV device, meaning you're in a short circuit condition. So at that point, when the boost supply is at 3 volts and we have a 3 volt drop across our electronic load, the PV device is in a short circuit condition and all of its current is flowing out through the E-load and through the boost power supply. Also, let's say our PV device has an open circuit voltage of 20 volts. So if our electronic load is at a high resistance or an open condition, it's going to have 23 volts dropped across it. 20 from the open circuit condition of the PV device and 3 from the boost supply. So when we do our measurements, we just have to compensate for that 3 volts. Keep in mind though, the boost supply, as we step through the different voltages, is not adding any current to it. It's just boosting the voltage potential of the PV device up. So one important consideration in this setup is when you're using a boost supply for PV testing with an E-load, is you want to make sure that the maximum amount of current that's going to flow out of the PV device, that the boost supply can handle that amount of current. For instance, if our PV device has a short circuit current of 7 amps, our boost power supply has to be able to handle 7 amps because the current is flowing through the boost supply. Other than that, our boost supply can be a pretty basic power supply. It doesn't need anything fancy. So now we have our panel under an illuminated light source, our floodlights. We have our boost supply on. And so now I'm going to turn on our electronic load. So the electronic load has very high power handling capability, so we're probably going to hear the fan come on a little bit. Okay, so I have the setup we just saw with the figure. I have our light powered on, so our panel is illuminated. Now this panel is about a 40 watt panel. Since our floodlights are less than ideal source of light, we're not going to get 40 watts out of there. We'll get maybe 12 watts. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to run this to step through the IV curve and capture the IV curve characteristics of the panel with the E-load, and I'm going to use Agilent's V software to do that. So I wrote a very simple program that's going to capture the IV curve as well as the PV curve and show some measurement parameters. Okay, so here's the results of our quick test. You can see on the left, we have some of our parameters, our max power point, our open circuit voltage, our fill factor, and our short circuit current. And then on the right, you can see the graph of our IV and PV curves. Now, of course, these were both built using the built-in voltage and current measurement capabilities of the electronic load. I measured 100 points for each. And of course, we used those voltage and current measurements to build both the IV and the PV curve. So fairly simple, one instrument to do the loading of the PV panel as well as make the measurements. And then we had one other additional instrument, a basic power supply, to serve as our boost power supply. So as you can see, it's pretty simple doing the test with the electronic load. For more information on Agilent's DC electronic loads, see the link at the top. For more information on Agilent's solar test solution and other solar resources, see the middle link. There you can find an application note entitled IV Curve Characterization in High Power Solar Cells and Modules. It's an application note that gives you more detail on using electronic load for PV testing. And then finally, in electronic design, you can find an article entitled A Photovoltaic Max PowerPoint Tracking Algorithm for DC Electronic Loads. In that article, it talks about using a max PowerPoint tracking algorithm, an ideal max PowerPoint tracking algorithm for using electronic loads. This is helpful for when you're testing PV panels or concentrated photovoltaics outdoors. The article can be found in the third link at the bottom, or you can simply type in MPPT algorithm electronic load into the Google search engine, and it'll be at the top of the list. Thank you very much.